All uniformed personnel, please rise.
To our families, Prescott firefighters, emergency services, ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the presentation of colors, our national anthem by our choir, and please remain standing for our opening prayer by Pastor Ron Merrill.
Present all.
so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare
family and friends of the fallen 19 Granite Mountain Hot Shot firefighters. We're here today because we love you. To the greater firefighting community, we're here today because we love you. And today, one of the best ways that we can express our love to those of you that are grieving would be just to pray for you. Would you join me? Father, if we're honest with you, and I'm thankful that we can be honest with you, this has felt like a bit of hell on earth this past week for these families of the fallen Granite Mountain hotshots, for their friends, for the firefighting community, and for their Yarnell and Prescott communities. We come before you broken and hurting and confused and numb. We know these sorts of events find their roots in our broken world, though, not in your lack of love. And while it's felt like a bit of hell on earth for the last week, would you, God, bring some heaven now? Maybe just a taste. Would you have it be as if these families and friends are standing under the waterfall of your love and grace and comfort and provision? Would you replace the darkness with light? Would you replace the despair with hope? Would you take the couple of hours that we have today and bring some of the way that things operate in heaven here to earth? I pray that your love would be thick in this place this morning. I pray that your comfort would be felt. I pray that we would sense Jesus closer than our breath. We thank you so much, God, for these heroes that laid down their lives for us. We thank you, though, that they were heroes before they lost their lives. Heroic men, heroic dads, heroic husbands, boyfriends, friends, siblings, sons, and workers. As they gave the ultimate sacrifice, we honor them today and thank you for their legacy. But God, in their absence, would you show up powerfully for the widows? Would you bind up the wounds of the brokenhearted here today? Would you keep your hands of protection over these little children left behind and the children that have yet to be born? Please keep these grieving souls healthy physically, spiritually, and emotionally in the months to come. We're desperate to see some of heaven now. Maybe see it even now as we hear stories and shed tears that prove just how much these men and their sacrifice meant to us. May it remind us of the sacrifice that your Son Jesus made on our behalf for all of eternity. It's in his powerful name, Jesus, that we pray these things. Amen.
Please be seated. We are gathered here this morning to honor and celebrate the lives of our fallen brothers. My name is Tim Hill. I'm the president of the Professional Firefighters of Arizona, and a firefighter in Phoenix for the past 29 years. I am deeply honored to assist with the ceremony for my fallen brothers. Today will be a celebration of their lives and service. We have prepared this program to further honor the families of our fallen, as well as the members of the Prescott Fire Department. We gather here as a community of friends, neighbors, brothers, and sisters in honor of the sacrifice made by our members. Some of these participants here served with these brave men. Our Vice President, Governor, and Mayor are here today representing all of the citizens of the United States, Arizona, and Prescott. Also attending are Dr. Jill Biden and longtime firefighter friend, Secretary of Homeland Security, Janet Napolitano, Secretary of Interior Sally Jewell, Senators McCain and Flake, Congressman Paul Gosar, who represents this congressional district, as well as numerous federal, state, and local officials. We are joined today by every member of the Prescott Fire Department, which includes the structural and wildland components, the fire chief, his command staff, and the alumni of the Granite Mountain Hot Shots are also with us today. In addition, we are joined by our forestry, wildland, and hotshot firefighters from across this great country, as well as IAFF union officials representing all of the professional firefighters throughout North America who are here to share in our grief and our fellowship. Further, even as we honor our members here, the city of Prescott remains safe. Professional firefighters from throughout Arizona and beyond are fully staffing all Prescott fire stations so our members could be here. Thank you all. Thank you for your overwhelming support for our families and this department and for your presence here today. It is now my honor to introduce Prescott Fire Department Division Chief Darrell Willis. Chief Willis was and is the father of the Granite Mountain Hot Shots. Today, he represents all of our Hot Shots and the wildland firefighting community. Chief Willis.
Thank you. Very kind introduction. I can't think of any higher honor or privilege than to be asked to speak today at this service. On behalf of the entire wildfire community nationally, I'd like to express my deepest condolences and their deepest condolences to each and every family member for your tragic loss. Look around. Take a minute to look around. I'm pretty colorblind today. There's not green trucks and white trucks and red trucks. You got family beside you, and you will have family beside you through the rest of your lives till we meet in eternity. I'm dressed in not a traditional structural uniform because I'm honoring the Hot Shots, the Granite Mountain Hot Shots. I know that's the way they wanted me dressed, with Yarnell dirt on my boots and the same uniform I was wearing the night that they perished, June 30th. I want to speak directly to you, the families, and I didn't know where to start. So I opened the Bible. It's the only one truth that I really know. And here's the good news that I found. In Philippians 1, 3 through 4, it's written, "Grace to you and peace be from God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God for the remembrance of you, always praying for you joy for all of you in my every prayer. I'm sure of that, I'm sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus." My intent today is to thank God for the remembrance of these 19 courageous young men and for allowing me to be a part of their lives. The Granite Mountain Hot Shots have charted new waters since 2004, and we continue charting those waters today. The vision of having a municipal hotshot crew has been far exceeded. This was not just a hotshot crew. It was the first and only municipal hotshot crew in the nation, and in my eyes, they were the best out of the 108 interagency hotshot crews in the nation. And I just took a big risk because there's a bunch of hotshots in this room, but they know where I'm speaking from. I thank God for their bravery, courage, loyalty, professionalism, humility. I thank God for their fitness, their work ethic, their cohesion, their teamwork, unbelievable humor and joy. That was the Granite Mountain Hotshots. But more than this, each and every one of them was my adopted son. I had personal relationships with all of them. I loved them, their hearts. I saw joy in the eyes of each one of them when they were doing their job. And by extension, I love every one of you. In every conversation I had with them, family was always a topic of conversation. They loved their families. They loved you. I thank God you were a priority in their lives. From the mundane, defensible space projects to the high-risk job they were engaged in on June 30th, everything they did, from family to work to play, was done with excellence. I have full confidence, and I am thankful that every action they took was well thought out, with safety as a top priority. I thank God that the leadership were the right men and that they led with confidence and mindfulness. Take comfort in the fact that I would have followed them blindfolded into the very place that they were at and have loved to have been right where they were at because I had full confidence in their decision-making process. They were diligent students of fire. They wanted to make sure they came home to you. A couple of years ago, I had the opportunity to travel with them to a fire assignment in Colorado. On the way back, we stopped in Glenwood Springs and hiked Storm King Mountain. We spent the entire sunny summer afternoon evaluating, studying, talking about what happened there 19 years ago. They were truly committed to never letting something like this ever happen again. They were committed to returning home to you after every assignment. But there was another plan. The motto of the Granite Mountain Hotshots is Esse Quam Verde. It means to be rather than to seem. These men, this crew, was the real deal. They brought everything to the table. They gave it their all. They were, in my words, right and tight. In closing, I pray for all of you the peace that passes all understanding. And I thank God for the opportunity and the remembrance of the 19 brave Granite Mountain Hotshots who gave their lives on June 30th so others could live.
The Prescott Fire Department is the oldest fire department in the state of Arizona. It protects over 40,000 citizens in a 42-square-mile area and responds to wildland, structural, hazardous materials, special operations, and emergency medical incidents. It is now my privilege to introduce the fire chief of the Prescott Fire Department, Dan Frejo. Prior to becoming chief in Prescott, Chief Frejo was a firefighter and a fire officer on my fire department in Phoenix. At the end of Chief Frejo's remarks, he will direct the honor guard to present to each of the families an American flag. Each of these flags was raised and lowered over the U.S. Capitol on July 1, 2013, at the direction of the Speaker of the House, John Boehner. Each family will also be presented with an Arizona flag. These Arizona flags were also flown over the state capitol on July 1st of 2013 and were provided by Governor Janice K. Brewer to represent all citizens of Arizona. The families will also be given a bronzed Pulaski tool that was provided by the Prescott National Firefighters. The Pulaski is a special tool which has been used by wildland firefighters for over 100 years. Chief Frejo.
I've been in the fire service for over half of my life, and I've had the opportunity to work with firefighters from North America many, many times. There's a common thread that everyone in uniform here has right now, and there's a bond that's attached to that thread. And that thread is that there's always a threat of something going wrong. There's always a threat of a risk. There's always a threat of the possibility of being injured and, God forbid, being killed in the line of duty. This is a business fact that we all accept, and our hot shots knew this and they accepted this risk. They never complained. They always went out there and they did a job with excellence, and I want you to know that I saw excellence that could be personified in these people, that could be written about. It can't be explained. It was just an absolute total dedication to their work. They did the best they could, and they were always respectful. They were always smiling. They were happy to do the job, and I appreciated it. But it was simply a job that they were going to do, and they were going to do it just like you and I might go to an office or wherever your place of work is. Wildland firefighting is a tough job, and this is something that me, coming from mostly the fire suppression community of cities or structures, was a little bit difficult for me to understand. I couldn't understand an individual that would be willing to consider a career of walking miles under dangerous ground conditions, carrying 40 to 50 pounds of gear, sleeping on the bare ground because they couldn't make it back to the camp, and dealing with the hazards that come from attacking a firestorm. I may not have understood it, but the 19 people that did. These 19 were dedicated to their jobs and served with total commitment and, as I said before, excellence. They were loyal, trustworthy, proud, and enthusiastic to go out there. They looked forward to facing the mouth of the dragon with a smile. It was an honor to be their chief. It was a privilege to know them. 9 days ago, we got the first news of the 19 of our ultimate people had sacrificed their lives in the line of duty. The entire nation was in shock and in dismay. To the city of Prescott, the Prescott Fire Department, and the hotshot friends and families, the impact of the disaster is even more horrifying. What happened on Yarnell Hill is still raw, and the feelings will likely not subside for a long time. Even so, I can assure you that our people will keep their heads up high and they'll move forward, even though they mourn through this enormous loss. We're gathered here today to honor 19 of our finest friends and colleagues. We would ask for to mourn and with their loved ones and to memorialize their sacrifice. Your very presence, support, generosity, admiration for their sacrifices are the honor you bestow upon them. Your sympathy for their loved ones, the heartfelt caring you show, your sympathy, empathy, and your profound sadness is our mourning. Your attendance, the memories of today, the solemn ceremony, and its importance on people all over America will forever memorialize this tragedy. I personally honor the wives and significant others of the fallen, their families, their friends, the fire service colleagues that sit around you, the first responders, and the community of the entire nation. On behalf of the Prescott Fire Department, I thank the many volunteers from across America who work countless hours to plan and coordinate the details of this enormous event. I wish I could personally thank the hundreds of people around the world that sent condolence cards, letters, and text messages to all of us, and especially to me. But if I could fulfill my fondest wish, it could be that my tears would wash away the pain and loss that we all feel. Rest in peace, my fellow professionals. You will be missed, but you will never, ever be forgotten. On behalf of all our members of the Prescott Fire Department, I now direct the Honor Guard to present the United States flag, the Arizona State flag, and the Pulaski tule.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now present the names of the fallen Prescott Fire Department Granite Mountain Hot Shot crew. In order to assist us with presentations, we ask only representatives from each family to stand, one representative from each family to stand when your loved one's name is called, and that you remain standing until the presenter reaches your seat. At that point, members of the family that wish should stand and jointly receive the American flag, the Arizona flag, and the Pulaski tule. Eric Shane Marsh. Jesse James Steed. Clayton Whitted. Robert E. Caldwell. Travis Clay Carter. Christopher Allen McKenzie. Travis Turbefill. Andrew Sterling Ashcraft. Joe B. Thurston. Wade Scott Parker. Anthony Michael Rose. Garrett Zupiger. Scott Daniel Norris. Dustin DeFord. William H. Wernicke. Kevin Joseph Wojak. John J. Persin. Grant McKee. Sean Michael Misner.
Presenters, ready, host.
And oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burden be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong.
I am now pleased to introduce the mayor of the city of Prescott, Marlon Kuykendall. Mayor Kuykendall has been a Prescott city councilman and was elected to the position of mayor in 2009. Mr. Mayor.
It's still morning, so I'd like to say good morning, families, and ladies and gentlemen. The Granite Mountain Hot Shots were the ultimate team of people, a family of brothers when they were away from their own families. But it's also very important that we remember that they were brilliant and caring individuals, each playing his unique and important role in this world. There were fathers brothers, sons, friends, mentors, leaders, and uncles. Whether they were born in Prescott or become a part of our community, we consider each of them to be one of our sons. And as an extension that each family is part of the community of Prescott. Prescott is a small town. And what I pledge to you today is that we will do our best to remember each man in his own right. We will be here to support you, to include you, to cry with you, to laugh with you, and to remember with you. Prescott will always be a home to you if you want us. We are honored to have you as a part of our family. I hope that commitment brings you some comfort as you struggle to move forward and remember your loved ones as they lived, full of life and promise and passion for you and their work, who loved you, but also loved being known as a Granite Mountain hotshot. In the fire world, these men were a world-trained crew who protected families, lives, and property across the nation. They made a difference to thousands of families with the work that they did and loved. The term fallen firefighters has been used to describe these men and their sacrifice. Today, I think of them not as having fallen, but rather as having risen. Risen far above any of us to a place of peace and comfort. To the families and friends, to the hotshot crews that are here today and who fought fires alongside our brave men, I pray for your healing. I hope that my words, and more importantly, that our continued support of you for years to come will bring you comfort. Thank you, and God bless.
At this time, I'm pleased to present our Governor, Janice K. Brewer. Governor Brewer has been an advocate of the firefighting community here in Arizona, and I've had the privilege of working with her on numerous issues to further protect our firefighters, their families, and our communities. Madam Governor.
Thank you, Tim. Mr. Vice President, Senator McCain, Senator Flake, Secretary Napolitano, Secretary Jewell, Governor Martinez, federal officials, members of Congress, state legislators, other state and local officials, and my fellow Arizonans, good morning. On behalf of the people of the state of Arizona, and especially the citizens in and around Yarnell, Peoples Valley, and Prescott, thank you for being here today. Together, we can begin our healing. Today, we come together to honor and mourn 19 brave men. They were protectors, defending our communities, safeguarding our friends, family, and strangers alike. They were 19 heroes, gone at the turn of the wind. To the families who lost husbands and fathers, brothers and sons, we cannot truly know your grief, but you are in our thoughts and prayers and will always be. Of course, our hearts are filled with profound sadness today, but they are also filled with great pride. How wonderful it is to know that Arizona was home to 19 men like those we honor today. While not all of the 19 men were from Arizona, we claim each one as our own. These men aspired to be wildfire land firefighters and endured the training and had the discipline to earn that title. Indeed, they were men who carried out their duties with honor, worthy of the name Granite Mountain Hot Shots. While we grieve and mourn the tragic loss of these great men and do our best to console their beautiful families, we cannot despair. God teaches us not to despair, but to have hope. Peter 5:10 says, "The God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while, will himself restore you and make you strong, firm, and steadfast." The brave 19 are now in the gentle embrace of God, and they continue to protect. I am filled with hope that comes with seeing the way Arizona and the communities of People's Valley, Yarnell, and Prescott have come together in the wake of this tragedy. It is hope born of firefighters from all over the country pouring into this region to battle Yarnell Hill Fire. I have hope because Arizonans, of course, have responded like I knew they would, with candlelight vigils and prayers, with generous financial contributions, with flowers and notes placed gently at makeshift memorials. This is the Arizona I know. The hope I have in my heart is fortified by knowing that Americans all across this country have prayed for the brave 19 we lost and their families, and have sought to provide resources to this community. To America, I say thank you. I also appreciate the swift assistance we've received from the federal government in tackling the Yarnell Hill Fire. I want to thank President Obama for his kind words in the wake of this tragedy and for offering any assistance our state needs during this trying time. Mr. Vice President, please convey our gratitude. Arizona and America are united in prayer and in a mission of recovery. With God's grace and with time, we will recover. To the Yarnell 19, we will never forget your sacrifice and that of your families. It is our duty now to help and to protect your families. May God bless and watch over them. May God bless and protect the many firefighters and first responders who serve so courageously every day. And may God bless the great state of Arizona and her people. It is now my honor to introduce the Vice President of the United States, Vice President Joe Biden.
Governor, thank you for introducing me. And our heart goes out to you and the mayor, the people of Prescott, and people of Arizona for the terrible tragedy you have endured. Chief Willis, Chief Frejo, President Hill, my good and close friend, President Schaeferger, who we have unfortunately shared too many stages like this, honoring fallen firefighters. To Brenda McDonough, thank God. And to the governor of Mexico, my friend, Governor Martinez. The seven members of Congress are here, in particular, Kristen, who was kind enough to meet me at the airport and welcome me to Arizona. And to Jeff, to Senator Jeff Flake, with whom we rode out on Air Force Two together. A genuine son of Arizona, five generations. And to my friend and companion for over three decades, a man I admire as much as any man I've ever met, John McCain. John knew my mom. My mom used to say, "You're defined by your courage and redeemed by your loyalty." I think I give no better definition of John McCain than that. A man like the men we honor today, a man of uncommon valor. Jill and I, along with the two secretaries that are with us today, your former governor and the Secretary of the Interior, Secretary Jewell, we're humbled to be here with you, standing in front of the families of the men we honor today, and so many, so many of their brethren. Psalm 122, verse 1 reads, "I will lift mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help." It came. It came in the form of 20 Granite Mountain Hot Shots who rushed toward the flames as everyone else retreated. And in the process, 19 of them gave their lives. These men were some of the strongest, most disciplined, tenacious, physically fit men in the world. An elite unit in every sense of that phrase. Their motto to me sums them up better than anything I can think of. Duty, integrity, respect. They saw their jobs not as jobs, but as a duty to their fellow citizens. They understood what few do, that integrity is measured by whether you respond to the needs of your neighbors when you know you are one of the few and only ones who has the capacity to respond. And respect, they showed respect time and again for those innocents caught in the path of the fires of hell, desperate to save their families, and in most cases, the one and only thing they truly owned, their home. These men, the Granite Mountain Hotshots, were part of a very small, elite band of firefighters only 108 hotshot crews in all of America, and many are here today to honor the fallen. To understand what I mean about their courage and valor, just look into the eyes of these men and women. Just look in their eyes. You need not do anything else to understand. These folks were firefighters who live life to the fullest every single day. They race to embrace life just as they race to embrace the fight against raging fires, the raging fire on Yarnell Hill. They embrace life to save lives. I didn't have the privilege, nor did Jill have the privilege, knowing any one of these heroes personally. But I know them. I know them. A cliff jumper, a rock climber, a mountain biker, a football player, an Iraqi vet, a Marine, a son of a firefighter. Oh, I know them. Confident, committed, determined, trustworthy, passionate. They were firefighters. I know them because they saved the life of my two sons. When a tractor trailer broadsided my daughter, my wife, and my daughter, and my two sons, my wife and daughter died. And but for my fire service, my two sons would have, but the jaws of life working for over an hour and a half saved them. They saved my guys, my firefighters, like all firefighters. They saved my life when, in the middle of a snowstorm, I had to be rushed to a hospital given a 30% chance of living with a cranial aneurysm. It was my fire company. Oh, I know them. You saved my home and my wife, Jill, when lightning struck my home and engulfed all three floors with the thickest of smoke that no one could enter. But thank God, one could leave. Jill and I know you. You're a rare breed. There's an old saying: all men are created equal, and then a few became firefighters. All men are created equal, but then a few became firefighters. Thank God for you all. Thank God for your willingness to take the risks you do. And we all owe you. But we also owe your families, to my left and my right, because you supported them. You supported these hotshots. The English poet John Milton wrote, "They also serve who only stand and wait. They also serve who only stand and wait. The 19 who fell were not only heroes on Sunday, June 30th, 2013, to you, the families. They were heroes long before we knew their names. you not only know, but now feel in your very bones the meaning of the words of John chapter 15, verse 13. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. What makes you family members so incredible? The husbands, the wives, the moms, the dads, the children, the brothers and sisters, is you knew, since they chose to be firefighters, since they joined the Hot Shot crew, you knew they were risking laying down their lives every single time they answered a call. Every time they walked out the door, you knew it may be the last time you'd see that confident smile, feel that tender touch, hear that voice saying, I love you. I love you. And from the time they breached the door, you lived in fear of that dreaded phone call, fearing the worst. And when it came, the pain and the loss were more profound than you ever imagined. I know. I remember getting that call. The feeling of being sucked into a giant void in your chest. The attempt to suspend reality, the sense of slow motion. My God, this can't be true. Yet, you supported them because you knew that firefighting was not what they did, it was who they were. And now, your loved ones join an incredible list of elite firefighters and a long history filled with ordinary Americans doing extraordinary, extraordinary things. Men of undaunted courage, common resolve, and an uncommon and stubborn perseverance in the face of unfathomable challenges. You know, we teach our children that these qualities of courage and resolve and perseverance, these qualities are ingrained in our national character as Americans. And I believe they are. I believe they animate our national identity, and I believe America will continue to be defined by the example of the 19 ordinary men who did extraordinary things. The amazing thing is that not one of them doubted the danger they faced. Not one of you in front of me doubt the danger you will face when the call comes again. And yet, you willingly take the risk. When you hear the call, you respond. And they responded as they always did, running toward danger, not away from it. The opposite of the human instinct. They acted. They acted as citizen patriots have acted since the beginning of this country. They stood up and they stood their ground. When we think of the 19, it gives us confidence as a people, confidence knowing that ordinary citizens have the capacity to do such extraordinary things, to stare down fear, overwhelm danger, and bring hope where there's nothing but hopelessness. Although it should continue to amaze us when it happens, it shouldn't surprise us. These acts of selflessness are a definition of who your husband, your brother, your son, your father was. My guess is, without knowing them, they weren't there just to fight fires. They were there to line the Little League field. They were there when somebody's car broke down. They were there. They were there. They were always there. My mother had another expression. She said, "Joey, courage lies in every heart, and the expectation is that one day it will be summoned." Well, on Sunday, June the 30th, 2013, it was summoned. 20 incredible men of valor answered the call, in doing so, to paraphrase John 15, chapter 23, laid down their lives so that others could live, 19 of them. And I know, we know, all of them were heroes long before, as I said, we knew them. They're the fathers who tucked you in bed at night, the husband who knew your fears before you even had to express them, the brother who lifted you up and made you smile. They're the son that brought you joy just seeing their face, made you proud and grateful to God that you had them. We know the irreplaceable. We all know that. But we know as well that no memorial service, no words, no acts can fill the void left in your hearts. But we also know that the collective spirit of your father, your son, your brother, your husband, that spirit lives on in every single one of you. And it inspires not only the 6,000 people in here and the thousands outside, but the millions watching and hearing about your family members as I speak. It lives on in the character of the hotshots assembled here today. It lives on in the heart of every firefighter who's ever answered the call. We owe you, the families, a gigantic debt far beyond what we can ever pay. I also know from personal experience at this moment, as unbelievable as it is, as unbelievable as it is to even fathom it, that the day will come when the memory of your husband, your son, your dad, your brother will bring a smile to your lips before it brings a tear to your eye. My prayer for all of you, that day will come sooner than later. But I promise you, as unbelievable as it is, it will come. It will come. In the words of the hymn we heard at the beginning, my hope for you is that may he lift you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, and make the sun to shine on you. Because it will. It will again. It will again. May God bless you all. May God embrace your family members. And may every family member know that there's an entire family, a brotherhood and sisterhood of firefighters that will be there for you the rest of your lives. God bless you all, and may God protect firefighters everywhere.
The fire officers and firefighters in the Prescott Fire Department are represented by the Prescott chapter of the United Yavapai Firefighters, IAFF Local 3066. It is my pleasure to introduce our local president and my friend, Dan Bates. For the past 9 days, Dan has literally been everywhere. The families of our fallen heroes, tending to their needs as well as assisting with their funeral arrangements to make sure that the wishes of each family are honored. Dan has also worked tirelessly to address the needs of his membership and their families during these very tragic times. Brother Bates.
I was waiting for that. All right, thanks. To all distinguished guests in attendance today, thank you for joining us. I stand before you today hoping to do justice to 20 heroes and an organization that continues to display heroism in the face of tragedy. I'm speaking of the 19 members of the Granite Mountain Hot Shots who gave the ultimate sacrifice on June 30th, 2013. And of Brendan McDonough, the surviving member of the Granite Mountain Hot Shots, who has carried on the strength and tradition of his fallen brothers. I'm also speaking of the Prescott Fire Department. Faced with an unimaginable loss, our organization has come together with love, compassion, and resiliency to mourn, honor, and carry on our mission of serving and helping others in their greatest time of need. 9 days. That's all it's been. In that time, we have grieved and cried together, shared emotions, and asked over and over one pointed question. Why? Personally, I've struggled with that question for days. Each time, I have returned to Jeremiah 29, verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. As hard as the past few days have been, as deep as this loss reaches, I believe there is strength to be found in that message. I believe these men were and are part of a divine plan. It's a thought that may be difficult, if not impossible, to comprehend. But I have faith that God placed these men here in Prescott for a reason. To establish their families here, to protect the community they loved, and to serve the folks who call this area home. Saints, placing a guarded hand over Prescott. And protect us they did, not just on June 30th, but for many years and in many ways. The Granite Mountain Hot Shot spent more than 500 days in the field directly battling wildfires. They were responsible for improving defensible space to more than 8,400 homes in Prescott and treating more than 1,600 acres of public land both in and around Prescott. They did public education. They authored community disaster plans. And they helped train other firefighters to do what they did. Keep us safe from fires like Yarnell Hill. They did snow removal during winter storms. They assisted with medical emergencies. They performed technical rescues. Anything Prescott needed, anything Arizona and this nation needed, these hotshots stepped up and filled the void. They didn't blink at danger. Their courage never wavered. In 2002, work done by the fields management team, later to become the Granite Mountain Hotshots, helped stop the Indian Fire from what could have been a disaster. And just weeks ago, they stood in the path of the Dose Fire up on Granite Mountain, the ground that gave this group its name, in the shadow of the historic tree saved by their efforts. Their efforts that day saved property and lives and spared so many from pain. I will remind you of Ephesians book 2, verses 8 and 9. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. Our saints of Prescott were not boastful men. Hotshots never are. They worked deep in the woods, removed from the public eye, far from headlines. The Granite Mountain Hotshots came from all walks of life, from different paths and different beliefs. But together, as one unit, they loved, honored, and served a purpose and a plan much greater than any of us. They shared a creed, esse quam verde, to be rather than to seem to be. These men took action. They were authentic in their purpose and unyielding in their commitment. Each was a man of this community, a leader. Many were men of deep faith. Stories of the crew reveal men who loved one another, laughed together, mentored, led, and ministered to each other. Many of the men gave their life to the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior, in their time with the Granite Mountain Hotshots. In June of this year, ministered by men of Granite Mountain, on the Thompson Ridge Fire in New Mexico, Brennan McDonough accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. June 30th, 2013, the Granite Mountain Hotshots had fulfilled their purpose God had planned for them. Saints watching over and protecting a community many call home. He called them home exactly how they wanted to go home. As brothers, fighting fire, placing themselves between life and death, quietly and humbly serving. One of the firefighters was once quoted saying, "I'd rather die in my boots than in a suit." Just before the final hike in to start battling the fire, one of the firefighters was texting his mother. The mother was concerned over the long month the men had spent fighting fire and the 100-plus degree temperatures in Yarnell. She wanted them to rest. The son replied, "Mom, the fire's getting big. There's a ranch down there. We need to go protect it." We will rest later. He closed by telling his mother he loved her. It was the last words she heard from him. Psalm 116, verse 5 tells us, "Precious is the sight of the Lord, is the death of his saints." What happened on June 30th on that hill may scald us. It may hurt like nothing we've experienced in our lives. But it was precious, and it was honorable. These 19 men were together as brothers. They were doing what they loved, and in all my heart, I know they had angels guiding them home. The fire, as hot it burned, may have consumed their earthly bodies, but are not our loved ones' souls. Isaiah 43, verse 2 tells us much. "When you pass through waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze." The fire passed over our sons, brothers, husbands, and fathers. It passed over 19 men we were privileged to serve beside at the Prescott Fire Department. These firefighters, our saints, were called to their eternal home. I can only imagine their welcome. All the loved ones who surrounded them, all the firefighters who met them in their moment of glory. That glory will not end when we leave this memorial service. It will not end though we go back to work, though one day our pain begins to dull, though life, as it always does, will have a way of going on. Brendan, my friend, my fellow firefighter, you have been in my heart, in all of our hearts, every second since June 30th. I have no doubt that you were spared for a purpose. Have faith and don't lose hope, Brendan, because I believe God has a plan for you. I also have no doubt that you will carry on the tradition and honor of our fallen brothers. One of the hot shots, Wade Parker, had a way with words. In college, Wade wrote a poem that I believe was God speaking through Wade as part of his plan, knowing this day would come. Brendan, I felt compelled to share these words with you. The message is a powerful one. I give my life to you. Forever I will serve you. You will be my strong tower and my refuge. Forever I will seek your face. Forever I will speak your word. Till the end of my days, I will speak your name into the world. So I lay my life down at your feet, the everlasting King. Be with me, Father. Let me not go astray. Protect me, Lord, and teach me your ways. To the families of the fallen, you too have been in every heart in this building, in millions of hearts nationwide and around the world in the last 9 days. You were not alone. You will never be alone. Our fallen brothers have left us with the gift of their families, and you will always, always be a part of our family. I claim no knowledge of what tomorrow holds, no insight into the plans of the future, but I do know that God has a plan. I do know that the Prescott Fire Department will carry on. And I do know that each and every man and woman who wears our uniform will continue to serve in a way that honors the sacrifice of the Granite Mountain Hot Shots, the Saints of Prescott. They may be gone, but they will never truly leave us. With the same fierce commitment, the Prescott Fire Department and our fire family pledges to all the families of our fallen. Brothers, sisters, we will always be here for you, every hour, every day. Thank you and God bless.
Representing the International Association of Firefighters is our General President, Harold A. Schaeferger from Washington, D.C. The IFF, 300,000 members strong, represents the professional firefighters in every state and province throughout the United States and Canada. At the end of President Schaeferger's tribute, he will direct the Honor Guard to present to each of the families the IFF Medal of Honor. This gold medal is awarded to the families of IAF Union members who were killed in the line of duty. The Memorial Medal bears the words dedication, honor, sacrifice. This medal so far has been awarded to 2,159 IAFF members killed in the line of duty since it was established in 1990. My friend, my president, Harold Schaeferger.
Governor Brewer, Mayor Kuykendall, Chief Frail, Senators McCain, Flake, members of Congress, members of the President's Cabinet, and Mr. Vice President, someone who has had the backs of all of our members, firefighters throughout this country, for so many years, having our backs not just with wonderful words, but with great deeds who have kept our members safe. 19 Prescott firefighters, 19 brothers in arms, bound together by the essence of the words honor, commitment, pride, courage, and sacrifice. Incredible men, highly trained to endure conditions beyond the capacity of most of us. Mentally strong and strong-willed, their job was to respond in areas where the forest burned wild. A unique band of men in the fire service. They work for the city of Prescott, but because of their incredible skills as the Granite Mountain Hot Shot crew, they also spent most of their time deployed by state and federal government, responding all across this country to those raging wildfires that the public views through the prism of their televisions. They were also 19 incredible husbands and husbands-to-be, fathers and fathers-to-be, sons, brothers, and friends. Several were second-generation firefighters following their fathers into our profession. Many found their way to what we refer to as the job through different journeys, but landing in the same place, where your crew becomes your second family. Most of the time, they worked up in the hills, among the trees and brush, on steep mountainsides and along cliffs. And where the general public can usually hear the sirens and see the rigs and hoses in the streets, watching firefighters step up to take on the flames and save lives when a home or high-rise is on fire in a neighborhood, where a store or a restaurant is engulfed in a strip mall, or a warehouse structure explodes. Hot shots operate differently. Most of the time, this incredible group and this incredible Granite Mountain crew was invisible to the people they serve, unseen, but so critically important. When lightning struck and ignited the dense, dry hills outside of Yarnell, where the sweltering heat wave already promised treacherous conditions, they geared up and moved out, knowing exactly what they were facing. Once on the ground in that rough terrain, they went to work, cutting lines, digging, scraping, carrying, fighting the fire with the wind at their backs, doing what they were trained to do. Then the backside experienced a wind blowout, gale force, 180-degree turn within a matter of minutes. Now the flames confronted them head on. With severe and powerful gusts, the hills got hotter and hotter. The dry chaparral at their feet fueling flames. A burnover was coming. These 19 comrades did what they were trained to do. They used the equipment they had. And as every crew does in every station and every department represented here today, they instinctively had each other's back. And while that combination of skills and commitment to each other had gotten them out of a number of tight situations before, two Sundays ago, it wasn't enough for 19 of Prescott's best. Most people don't fully comprehend. They can't comprehend the culture and the bond of our profession, where we live together, work together, we eat our meals together, we watch our families grow, and we put our lives on the line in each other's hands. The Granite Mountain Hot Shot crew, they spent days, weeks at a time, deployed in the wilderness together. And the only thing they had for certain was each other, their second family. In this profession of ours, the fact is we have two families. We have our wonderful, loving, immediate families at home. And then we have our firefighting family on the job. But today, we are all one family, the loved ones of the Yarnell Hills 19. Just look around this arena and the thousands that are outside who have come to honor the best of the best. Everyone bound together by these unbelievable men, these tenacious firefighters who simply were doing their job. They're like ripples from a pebble in the pond, all of these in their uniforms, extending out beyond themselves to an incredible number into one great family. A family that's come together to mourn, to remember, and to pray for those we lost. Together to celebrate their lives, to honor their service and sacrifice. Einstein once said that a life lived for others is a life worthwhile. The men we lost in those hills lived and served for others, for all of us. They chose saving lives and protecting the citizens and country they loved as their profession. Each full of life, 14 of them in their 20s, all too young. Some served in another proud uniform of the United States and the armed forces. Some headed straight for this great profession, but all were adventurers. They treated every day like it was special. Each one had so much more left to do here on Earth. They all will be missed. Sadly, in the fire service, we experience loss in the line of duty some 100 times a year. And then there are the terrible times when we lose multiple members in a single incident. This year alone, in just the last 6 months, we've honored those who have fallen in multiple losses in Bryan, Texas, Indianapolis, West Texas, and Houston just 1 month ago. But not since September 11, 2001, have we suffered a blow as massive as June 30, 2013, the Yarnell Hill fire, a day we will never forget. To the immediate families and friends of our fallen, and to those in uniform standing at attention here today and who have served with them, and especially Brendan McDonough, to you, I'm so thankful to see you here with us today. And thankfully, we are simply here to honor and to extend our profound respect to all of you. We offer our internal gratitude and prayers. You will always be part of our extended firefighter family, you, the loved ones of those we lost. We will stand by you not just today, not just tomorrow, but for the months and years to come. We say thank you for sharing your loved ones with us. We will miss them greatly. To Andrew, Robert, Travis, Dunson, Christopher, Eric, Grant, Sean, Scott, Wade, John, Anthony, Jesse, Joe, Travis, William, Clayton, Kevin, and Garrett. You have answered the final alarm. You have served your nation well. Thank you for the gift of your lives. May you rest in peace. And remember that those names of our fallen will be etched on the beautiful granite walls in Colorado Springs, where generations of firefighters will come to honor their service and to always remember. And now, on behalf of our entire executive board and the 300,000 men and women of the International Association of Firefighters, I would now ask the Honor Guard to present the IFF Gold Medal of Honor to our families.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now present the names of the fallen Prescott Fire Department Granite Mountain Hot Shot crew. In order to assist us with presentations, we ask only one representative from each family to stand when your loved one's name is called, and that you remain standing until the presenter reaches your seat. At that point, members of the family that wish should stand and jointly receive the IAFF Medal of Honor. Eric Shane Marsh. Jesse James Steed. Clayton Whitted. Robert E. Caldwell. Travis Clay Carter. Christopher Allen McKenzie. Travis Turbyfill. Andrew Sterling Ashcraft. Joe B. Thurston. Wade Scott Parker. Anthony Michael Rose. Garrett Zupiger. Scott Daniel Norris. Dustin DeFord. William H. Wernucki. Kevin Joseph Wojak. John J. Persin. Grant McKee. Sean Michael Misner.
The surviving member of the Prescott Fire Department Granite Mountain Hot Shots is Brendan McDonough. Every firefighter and every member of this community feels blessed that he is with us here today. It is my honor to introduce my brother firefighter, Brendan McDonough.
My brothers, my sisters, my family, I'd like to share the Hot Shot prayer with all of you. When I am called to duty, Lord, to fight the roaring blaze, please keep me safe and strong, that I may be here for days. Be with my fellow crew members as we hike up to the top. Help us cut enough line for this blaze to stop. Let my skills and hands be firm and quick. Let me find those safety zones as we hit and lick. For if this day on the line, I should answer death's call, Lord, bless my hotshot crew, my family, one and all. Thank you, and I miss my brothers. And we're here today to remember them. And I love my family, all of you that are out there. Thank you for supporting me.
Thank you.
The men and women of today's fire service are confronted with a more dangerous work environment than ever before. We are forced to continually change our strategies and tactics to accomplish our mission. Our methods may change, but our goals remain the same as they were in the past: to save lives and to protect property, sometimes at a terrible cost. This is what we do. This is our chosen profession. This is the tradition of the firefighter. The fire service of today is ever-changing, but it is also steeped in traditions that are over 200 years old. One such tradition is the sounding of a bell. In the past, as firefighters began their tour of duty, it was the bell that signaled the beginning of that day's shift. Throughout the day and night, each alarm was sounded by a bell, which summoned these brave souls to fight fires and to place their lives in jeopardy for the good of their fellow citizens. And when the fire was out and the alarm had come to an end, it was the bell that signaled to all the completion of that call. When a firefighter died in the line of duty, paying the supreme sacrifice, it was the mournful toll of the bell that solemnly announced a comrade's passing. We utilize these traditions as symbols which reflect honor and respect on those who have given so much and who have served so well. To symbolize the devotion that these brave souls had for their duty, a special signal of three rings, three times each, represents the end of our comrades' duties and that they will be returning to quarters. And so, to those who have selflessly given their lives for the good of their fellow man, their task completed, their duties well done, to our Prescott brothers, their last alarm, they are going home.
Present on!
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the video monitors in order to view a Marine Corps flyover. Marine Corps Yuma Air Station is providing the flyover in recognition of the role that air support plays with wildland firefighters and in recognition of the contribution to our country's defense by Marine Corps veterans who made up a portion of our Granite Mountain Hot Shot crew. Please view the monitors.
Thank you. the truth.
And the families of the fallen. After the Prescott firefighters have left the center, the honor guard will dismiss all uniformed personnel, followed by the families of the fallen. Please follow the commands of our honor guard. With that, will all attendees other than the uniformed personnel that are being dismissed, please remain in your seats until dismissed by the honor guard. Honor guard, dismissal at your command.
report to the Sea of Blue. Reported location. Ready? Post. were the Honor Guard family escorts report to their families and begin the dismissal. Ready? Post!
Oh,